Okay, welcome back. This is the final discussion for our Working with Music Teachers series. And this is my favorite subject. It's the final subject, part six, practice. The most important part of musical study is practice. Again, it seems really obvious, but what we're discussing here, and the reason we're discussing this here, is because it's important to stress the idea of developing good habits early on, instead of trying to break bad ones. The funny little secret in music study is that practice is more important than lessons. Someone who commits themselves to studying music on their own will learn. Now, of course, music teachers can help to make this process easier and more interesting, and having somebody to guide you through will make sure that you or your child learns correctly. But the truth is, anybody can learn music on their own. So, we live in hectic times, it's just a fact. Everybody is so busy. Young people today are sometimes involved in as many as three or four or more after-school activities. It's very different than when I was growing up. Now, as I said before, we could have a very, very long conversation regarding how healthy this is. But for now, we'll just accept it and try to deal with the truth of our reality. So if you're just starting out, remember what was said about good habits, that we want to develop good habits early on as opposed to breaking bad ones later. So if you are just starting out, make sure that on the very first lesson, your student has a notebook for a practice log, okay, or a practice log, and some kind of recording medium. And remember that this was for recording the instructor demonstrating exactly what they want the student to be doing at home. The instructor will, hopefully, write down specifically what the student should be working on, including page numbers and tips on which to focus, and then record the instructor recapping what was gone over in the lesson. You don't want to do this every time because it's important for the student to develop self-sufficiency, meaning that they should be able to read the music on their own, they should be able to play their melodies for themselves, and so on and so forth. But in the early stages, it really does make practice much easier. So at home, when it comes time to practice, the student should have a practice space as quiet and as private as possible. Okay, if possible, it should be the same time every day. And, you know, if they can do it in their bedroom where there is no TV, there are no distractions, that's better yet. A lot of parents will ask students to practice in the family room or, you know, where there's a lot of traffic and it can be very distracting. So I personally like to budget a certain amount of time for each activity in my own practice. So for instance, this is my practice schedule, the one that I use most commonly. I spend about 15 minutes on warming up and technique, then 15 minutes working on songs. These are new songs or new material that I need to be learning. 15 minutes in sight singing or sight reading and ear training. And then 15 minutes reviewing music that I like to play. It's always important to keep up on music that you enjoy. And yes, I actually do set a timer so that I don't go over because I can lose track of time easily sometimes. Normally, once the student starts to experience progress in their music, practice will become less of a chore. It's something that students will start to look forward to, which is wonderful when that happens. But please don't use practice time as a punishment. It sets up the wrong association and often sours the student very quickly against music. So if the student is not practicing, and we went over this in the first video, some things that you can do are remedialize. You can go to a simpler book. There's nothing wrong with that. It's much better to simplify than to quit. You can look at ensemble opportunities for your child or the student. Recording the teacher is always a great option. And of course, maintaining a practice log. So some additional important points is remember that any practice time is better than no practice. A lot of times, a student feels like if they can't put in the full hour or 15 minutes, depending on what your instructor recommends, then the student will say, what's the point? The most important thing is developing a routine. If you have to start small with that routine, it's perfectly okay. So finally, if you have tried all of this and your student is still not practicing and it's miserable, you might want to think about a different instrument or switching to voice lessons. Singing is a very beautiful, natural thing for students, and it teaches musicianship in a way that no other instrument really can. So, of course, it's sad if you had to bid farewell to piano lessons or violin lessons or, you know, whatever it is that your student was initially interested in. But the bigger picture is to keep with music. So. All right, as always, thank you so much for watching. If you have any opinions, please feel free to write in the comments section. If it was helpful for you, please consider subscribing. And I would love to hear any response videos, especially if I missed anything or if you feel like you have a good counterpoint to the points that I was making. So have a wonderful day. We'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.